Hey everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is Kathy, and for today's video, we are back to talking about diamond painting. I know that I have not uploaded a single diamond painting video for the longest time. I've been doing a lot of unboxings, quick reviews, but for today's video, it's going to be something pretty special and different because I've actually been observing that there has been a lot of diamond painters who have felt a little bit burnt out or nagsawa na and they don't want to do diamond painting anymore. And so, for today's video, we will be talking about the 5 ways that you can avoid diamond painting burnt out. If this is something that is of interest to you, please stay tuned. Okay, so we are back again. My name is Kathy, and on this channel, we talk a lot about diamond painting, journaling, unboxings, quick reviews, and from time to time, we share few tips here and there to, you know, find your happy and be a better person. If that is your kind of thing, I hope that you can hit the subscribe button, ring the notification bell. I randomly upload videos. I'm trying to, you know, really schedule things, and I'm hoping that for the latter half of the year, I will be able to find a schedule and stick to it. But at this point, I randomly upload new videos. But I do upload videos every month. So I hope you can ring the notification bell so that you can be notified when there's a new video up. And I hope that you can like and share or leave a comment on this video if you find this video has been truly helpful to you. So we're just going to go ahead and dive right in on the 5 ways that you can avoid diamond painting burnout. So what is diamond painting burnout? It is that feeling that you get when, you know, you used to feel passionately about something, you love it, you want to do it every single day from morning till night, and then suddenly, bam! Ayoko na, I don't want to do this anymore, I'm sick and tired of it. That's called a burnt out. It means that you got too much of it, maybe, you know, it consumed you too much. But there is a way to actually avoid that. So if you feel that you're at that point already, nearing that point, I hope that you can give a listen to this. So tip number one, go big and small. What does that mean? There are a lot of, you know, really small diamond paintings, like the 30 by 40, which we call the budget ones. But there are also a lot of really huge diamond paintings, like wall-sized diamond paintings. And what I notice is that a lot of newbies tend to go small and then big, 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 big. And they feel overwhelmed because it can be overwhelming. Imagine doing a diamond painting of the Spolarium. That's huge, right? But it's also amazing if you finish it. But you have to remember that there are other things happening in your life that could get in the way. And so you might not be able to come back to diamond painting. And then you see it and you get overwhelmed because it's so huge. And you're like, I can't finish this. So you're just gonna chuck it away and that's it. Goodbye. Sayang naman. So what you do is you go big and small, or you go small, medium, large. You know, you do a budget-sized diamond painting. You do a medium-sized diamond painting, say a 50 by 60 or 50 by 70. And you do a big one. And then you go back to doing a small one, just so there's some sort of balance, and you know your brain is not overwhelmed that it's all big diamond paintings, it's all big diamond paintings, it's all big diamond paintings. So go big and small. Second one that I noticed is that a lot of people tend to jump the bandwagon. What does that mean? Gaya gaya. That's not really a bad thing, except if gaya gaya ka, or you jump on the bandwagon just because everyone's doing the same design, but you don't really like it, and yet you buy it, and then you're struggling to finish it because you don't like it. Remember that with diamond painting, there's a lot of face-to-face interaction or face-to-beads interaction. You're gonna look at that canvas for a while, for at least a few weeks. So you wanna make sure that you like what you're looking at, okay? You have to make sure that you love what you're looking at, what you're spending hours and hours on. Because if you don't, if you're just doing the diamond painting because everyone else is doing it, you're not going to be able to finish it. And then you might feel burned out, and then you're gonna turn your back on diamond painting. Sayang naman. Now, the next one, don't rush. I have said this so many times on my diamond painting group. Do not rush. Stop rushing. There is no contest. There's no grand prize for the first one who finishes a kit more than the others, okay? There is none. Diamond painting should be relaxing. It should make you feel relaxed. It should make you feel that, you know, your mind is at ease. You're just doing one bead to the next, one bead to the next, one bead to the next. So no rush, okay? There's no medal or prize for the person who will finish a diamond painting first. The fourth one is take breaks. It's okay to take a break. You're still finishing something, but you feel like you just want to lie down, Netflix, and chill. Go ahead and do that. Come back to your diamond painting next week. Again, it should be your own timeline. It should be your own timetable, so to speak. You want to do it? Do it. You don't want to do it? Then it's okay. Don't force yourself. Unless you're being commissioned or paid to finish something and there's a deadline, then that's the only time that you have to force yourself, because now it's work. But if this is just your passion, stop pressuring yourself. And the most controversial tip that I will be giving is pursue other hobbies. Why? Do you feel like it might feel like you're turning your back on diamond painting or betraying diamond painting? But really, pursue other hobbies, because it is how you will learn to appreciate diamond painting more. So in the last 2 weeks, I've tried wax sealing. I don't know if you guys are familiar, you know, you melt the wax and then you stamp it. And it looks so pretty on TikTok. It looks so pretty on the videos. But I've learned that I actually felt a little bored with it. It's not something that I can see myself pursuing in the long run. So I now have like a letter key and the cat one. But that's it. I don't think I'll be adding more to it. And I realized that diamond painting is still the one thing that I prefer to do. It's something that relaxes me, relaxes my head. And it's something that I want to keep on doing. And I appreciate it more because I tried other hobbies and I realized that, oh, I prefer diamond painting more compared to this other one. So, you know, it's not bad. Pursue other hobbies. Try stamp cross stitch. It's also like diamond painting, but, you know, cross stitch made easier. There's nothing wrong with that. I'll actually even link up a video, so you should be able to see it here, that I made about stamp cross stitch. There's nothing wrong with that, okay? It's okay to love many different things. It's okay to try out many different things. What's not okay is that you force yourself to do something to the point that you get burnt out and you turn your back on it. So I hope that this video was helpful to you. If you are feeling any of the signs, like you dread finishing your kit, you are forcing yourself to finish your kit, you find that you are losing interest, that you don't check out the Facebook groups that you've joined anymore, that's a good sign that you are feeling burnt out. And you can try out some of the tips I've given, or, you know, you can take a break and then just come back to it a few months later. Again, no harm in that. So again, my name is Kathy. I hope that this video was helpful to you, and I hope you enjoyed it as much as I did. I'll see you guys on the next video. Mwah!